There you go, Gal. So we're going to go in with MN7 now. That's this map here. This is where things start to get a little bit choppy. All right. So I'm up to a 4-star group. If you've been watching my previous videos, this is where I think you should probably start having some decent operators in there, because we're pretty much at the limit of what a 3-star team can do effectively. You can weasel your way through this with a 3-star team, but you're probably not going to be loving your life. Two standard vanguards rounds us out. Puri is good for this because he is nice and tanky. Scavengers and temp. Two standard healers. You can use Susurro with skill 2 if you prefer. Doesn't really matter. I'm using Gavial for my other one. If you have an AoE healer, feel free to use an AoE healer. Where we will have Gavial, our tank, down there, who is going to be Courier. Shouldn't be taking a lot of damage. And obviously, Perfumer has an AoE map heal, so if you have Perfumer, use her. If you don't have Perfumer, just use a single target. It's whatever. Two standard defenders. Preferably ones with defensive skills, because they will be taking a decent whack of damage. Gitano is using skill 2. Any AoE any AoE caster will work. Ideally, you'll be using Skyfire, but again, if you only have Gitano, you only have Gitano, skill 2. We have Vermeil with skill 2. She's going to be helping with drones. That's why we've got the split shot skill, so she can keep doing damage on other things. Once more, ideally, you'll be using blue poison. Meteor, because we're killing drones, so why the heck not? Grab Meteor if you've got her. If you don't have her, simply use Jessica. That's fine. Armia, I'm hinging towards skill 2. If you want to use skill 1, that's up to you. Now, if you have a low group, I don't know, entry level E2, you'll probably want to bring a single target Vanguard just to get you through the start. And we're also just going to grab Castle 3. And Castle 3 is just going to be there as a little bit of reserve damage. And you'll see what I mean when we get there. Alright, so let's get into this. If this helps you out, guys and gals, please leave a sub, because that helps me out quite a bit. And we're going to need to be pretty specific about where we pop Courier, so bear that in mind. So, what we're going to do, Scavenger top lane, fast forward, Courier bottom lane. Pop in Vigna here. You can face Vigna up, up or down if you want. Doesn't matter. It's whatever. I've got a facing forward. First skill cycle, we're going to get Vermeil in down the bottom. Facing up. Armia up the top, facing down in the center lane. We need her in the center lane, guys. The reason we need her in the center lane, obviously, sorry, because of her extra range, I'm just in my own little world. Let's get this skill going just to get that bug down. Gitano here, facing up. We'll fast forward this. Let's get our healers in. So Perfumer here, facing across, so she can heal up Vermeil if Vermeil gets damaged. You'll notice that my Perfumer does indeed have her module equipped, so bear that in mind. It's not going to make a huge impact, but it's worth mentioning. Facing down with Pedenko. Suzuru. Sorry, not Pedenko. This drone needs to die. Full stop. Now, Armia's skill has activated, which is a good start. We're going to use Vermeil's skill anyway, just to make sure that it does. And that gives us some woodcutters. So, what we want to do with our woodcutter is cut down this tree here. And with that tree, we're also going to pop in Castle. And Meteor. Alright, now, this first big guy, I'm not too fussed about him. But what I am going to do is I'm going to wait for him to come in. He's going to put his spell on someone, and it is going to be... should absolutely be Vigna. There it goes. So I'm going to leave Vigna there anyway, because she still has 1,000 attack, which is fucking monstrous, let's be dead honest. So I'm just going to let Vermeil go through. Vigna, sorry, not Vermeil. I know who my operators are, honest. So once this second guy comes through, I'm going to bomb them. Because I want this skill to do absolutely all that it can. And then I'm going to pull her out and replace with Quora. And at this point in time, I'll replace my second defender, who's going to be Bubble. And now this is where the hairy bit starts, because obviously Amiya's skill has cycled here, which puts her down for a little while. It's not a crippling down, but it's enough. So we need to use Vermeil's skill, keep that on the cycle, so she can absolutely get as much damage through as we can. Now, I don't expect Meteor to get this enemy. If she does, fantastic. If she doesn't, it is what it is. It's nothing I'm too upsetty spaghetti about. So here comes another drone box. This one I do kind of care about. Amiya should get that. There it goes. Actually, no, I don't care about that. That's more of these. Must be this one that has the bombs in it. Anyway. Tis what tis. Let's get Vermeil's skill cycling. Ah, there's the bombs. It was in one of those. Righto. I thought I got bombs from somewhere when I was doing this in practice. Alright, this is the wave we care about, right, guys? This is what we've been saving Gitano's skill for. This is what we've been saving Suzuro's skill for. This is what we've been saving our tanks for. This is basically what we've been just throwing everything out for. So, what are we doing here? Well, first and foremost, we're going to bomb these guys. I'm going to use Vermeil's skill, because I really just want to wait for as long as I can. So, okay, Gitano's debuff is off. We're going to use her skill, and then we're going to bomb these guys again. Army is still debuffed, but I can't do anything about when she cycles her skill. I'm stuck on that. Alright, so everything else is down. Courier doesn't need to be here. Bubble doesn't need to be here. Vigna does need to be here. Even though I probably just deployed her too early, but that's alright. Don't do what I just did. That's not what you do. Alright, so now he's gonna get revived, obviously. And we're gonna do our usual bit and bob. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go Suzuro first. Super important, Suzuro first. Seeing as how I don't have my Vigna anymore, I'll use Scavenger instead, but ideally you want Vigna here. Don't do what I did. Do as I say, not as I do. Alright, so Suzuro just got a debuff, which is not great. She'll still be fine because she gets a healing boost. But once that skill expires, we swap. And if you're still low of damage afterwards, if you don't cock up like I did and you do put Vigna there, you should be fine. But if you do bugger it up like I did, Suzuro's skill will have cycled by the time the shield comes down off Quora. So just flip-flop them. And you should be fine. I hope that helps, guys. I know that was a lot coming out of my big fat gob, but that's all right. I hope it helps.